Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about frequency distributions today. Frequency distribution or frequency table shows how a data set is partitioned among all of the several categories or classes. By listing all the categories along with the number of data values in each of the categories. And that sounds more complicated than it actually is. And we'll look at some examples in the following videos of actually organizing data. But what a frequency distribution table does is it summarizes a data set. And we construct it in such a way that it lets us see the shape of the distribution without distortion, meaning we don't want to make it look different than it actually is. We want it to look true. And so typically we use 5 to 15 equally sized classes, depending on how big our data set is. So if these are my class values from 1 to 5, 6 to 10, 11 to 15, 16 to 20, and 21 to 25. And then inside the class, I have a frequency or associated with the class. So let's say I was looking at the age of people that came into an ice cream shop one evening. And then I would look and say, well, between the ages of 1 and 5, there were 3 people. Between the ages of 6 and 10, there were 7 people. So the frequency is just the number of people that fit into that class, or whatever it is. It doesn't have to be people. And then I can construct a histogram to go with that. A histogram uses quantifiable data, and then the bars touch. And the height of the bar is defined as the frequency for that class. So in the class 1 through 5, I had a frequency of 3, so the bar is 3 high. In the second one, 6 through 10, I had 7. 11 through 15, I had 8, and then 2, and then 1. So my frequency is here. If I asked about cumulative frequency, well, cumulative frequency would be how much do you have if you add all those up? 3 plus 7 is 10, plus 8 is 18. Plus 2 is 20, plus 1 more is 21. So the cumulative frequency would be 21 because that's how many people came into the ice cream shop that night. So that's a look at a histogram. But we don't always have to use histograms when we have a distribution table. There's other graphs we can do, and I'm going to go into detail about these graphs in another video. But the histogram we just talked about, a frequency polygon is a type of line graph. It comes all the way down to the axes when you're drawing those. And the ogive is something that uses that cumulative frequency. So it just keeps going up and up and up. And if we were using our ice cream example, that would have ended up here at 21, right? This is a different ogive. But so they have different purposes. The frequency polygon uses the midpoint. In the histogram uses the classes. So I want to give you a few definitions, and I'm just going to leave this up on the screen in case you want to write those down or anything. I've got them so they all fit into one screen there. We have the lower class limits. In our set above, we had the first group was 1 to 5 years old, if we talk about as ages. Well, the lower class limit then is 1, and the upper class limit on that is 5. So just when you talk about class limits, there's 1 on the end and there's a 5 on the other end. Those are our upper and lower class limits. The class boundaries are a little more complicated. Remember that we don't have any gaps. And so we have to be able to put people into categories. And so think about this as like the class width goes up to 5 and the next one starts at 6. What about something that's in between 5 and 6? And what we do is we just take the two numbers, the high limit and the next following low limit, and we add those together. And 6 and 5 is 11, and divide by 2, and that gives us 5.5. So the class boundary would be 5.5 here, 10.5, 15.5, 20.5, and so forth. We use 5 because that's what we get when we divide by 2 when we have whole numbers like that. All right, the class midpoints are just the average of the upper and lower. So the class midpoint for our 1 through 5 would be 1 plus 5 is 6, divided by 2 is 3. The class width in our problem is 5, and you get that by taking the lower limit and subtracting the one below it. So 6 minus 1 is 5, or 21 minus 16 is 5. Or you can use the upper limit, 25 minus 20 is 5. 20 minus 15 is 5. But we know that the class width comes from the difference of either the lower, sequentially, the lower and upper or upper class limits gives us the class width. Relative frequency is taking the number that applies and divide in for that class and dividing it by all of it, the cumulative frequency. So we could say for this one, 3 divided by 21, because 21 was our total and this is 3 out of 21, we could divide to get that answer. And then if you want it as a percentage, you multiply that by 100 and then that would give you the percent frequency. And the cumulative we talked about before is just adding up all of the frequencies that you have there. All right, that's it for this video. The next video I'm going to do is going to be frequency distribution example, and we're going to go through all of these definitions so that they make more sense to you. Have a